friends, I have started question and answers which can be helpful for you in different aspects like delivering interviews or going for any competitive exams, in which very basically there have some fundamental questions related with electrical which we have to answer. So today I have selected some questions from my parallelly running series of fractional horsepower motors. I have selected some questions from this and I am going to answer that questions today in this video. So let's start. Our first question is, what happens if centrifugal switch will not operate? Okay. Second question is, what happens if centrifugal switch will not operate in case of capacitor start motor? So here is also one important thing, means in first two questions there is one answer, that centrifugal switch, how it work or how it perform, it is not just depends on its the centrifugal switch, but also depends on which type of motor it is. Third question, describe rotor frequency. That means, what is exactly rotor frequency? Because basically we know that we have 150 hertz frequency. So how this rotor frequency comes, what is its different aspects, I am going to answer that. Fourth question is, why we use mostly capacitor in single phase induction motor? Capacitor is a component by which we can split the phases, but why we use mostly capacitors? And fifth question is, which components we can add in split phase induction motor starting winding to start motor? Let's begin with our first answer. What happen if centrifugal switch will not operate? There are different aspects of every answer, so I have wrote here all the aspects. First is, centrifugal switch not operate means switch will not open. So you have to understand what is the question. So question is, centrifugal switch not operate, that means it will not open. Second thing, it result that starting winding will keep running. So here is the our answer, that starting winding will continuously going to run. It result that starting winding will keep running continuously throughout the working, and it will face lot of copper losses. So when it will going to run continuously, it will definitely create lot of copper losses. Now what happened, as a starting winding is designed only for small time, so its thermal efficiency is not as good as main winding, and hence it will damage and stop working. Still you have any doubt, you can ask in comment box. Second thing, question, what happen if centrifugal switch will not operate in case of capacitor start motor? Now I have another type of motors which having capacitor and centrifugal switch. That means this is capacitor start induction motor. Now in capacitor start induction motor, as we know, there have capacitor and centrifugal switch to disconnect starting winding as well as the starting capacitor from the circuit. So here their explanation is, centrifugal switch not operate means switch will not open. It result the starting winding will keep running. So it is but obvious, it result that starting winding will carry huge current. Okay, so here we have now a huge current will carry through the starting winding. As starting winding is designed for working only for small time, so its capacitor also having less value. So now in capacitor start motor, their capacitor having a very small value capacitors we use, and hence the capacitor connected in starting winding will damage. In this type of motor, capacitor start motor, rather than damaging starting winding, its capacitor will get damaged and motor will stop working. So this is another one concept. You have to understand this, that rather than damaging its winding, it will damage the capacitor. Third question, describe rotor frequency FR. We know that we have a basic frequency which is 50 Hertz, but in rotor we are getting a different frequency. So I am going to explain what is that rotor frequency. First answer is, because of electromagnetic induction, rotor gets its own EMF. Second, the rotor EMF produces its own current and frequency. Now this is an independent EMF which has been formed in rotor, so it will create separate or their own current as well as frequency. Third thing, basically frequency and speed is correlated. Ns is equal to 120 f by p. Formula for getting the synchronous speed, ns means synchronous speed. In rotor, it will be n is equal to 120 fr by p. Speed of rotor is different than stator's flux speed. That's why we can rewrite that formula in n is equal to 120 fr by p. As speed of n is less than stator flux speed, ns, hence frequency is also different. So if you will put a different speed than ns, then you will definitely get a different frequency here, because if the motor is same, p is constant, 2 or 4, they are only in even numbers, because we need two poles n and s for completing one set. So it should be in 2, 4, 6, 8, a speed of rotor n less than stator flux speed, ns, hence frequency is also different, that is true. This is how we can describe rotor frequency FR. Fourth question, why we use mostly capacitor in single phase induction motor? It is also having some different aspects. So first is, capacitor having leading component of current which result in obtaining torque, because we know the characteristic of capacitor, which in which current is lead to voltage by 90 degrees. So it having leading component, that means it having leading component of current. As current is required for work done, if we have extra current, it will be help the machine to achieve maximum torque in small time. We know that we need current, means when the current will drop, the work will be done. So if because of capacitor we will get extra current, that means it will help us to get the work done more smoothly. Third thing, it result that machine will run with huge torque or high torque. As in second part, I have explained that the work will done with the extra current very smoothly. That result, machine will run with high torque. If there is no restriction, no lack of current, then definitely their torque will be high. But same time, because of leading current, the noise of machine reduce, as the less losses inside machine can be fulfilled with the current provided by capacitor. So from first three parts, we will understand that our capacitor can improve our current characteristic of machine. But same time, we have got one extra benefit from this, and that is, it will reduce the noise of machine, because of there is no any load on motor or machine. As we have good current characteristic, the noise will but obviously get reduced. Question number 5, which component we can add in split phase induction motor starting winding to start motor? The answer is, single phase induction motor is not self starting. Then I have to create two phases, and that's why I split my one phase into two. But how it will act as two different phases if their frequency is similar, if their phase angle is similar, because they are run through the single phase or same phase. So how it motor can feel like it having two different phases? So for that purpose, we have to create minimum two phases to rotate the machine. And by using capacitor or resistor, we can create phase difference between two current and they will act as a two different phases. So we can use either capacitor or resistor to create one phase. But obviously our main winding included huge inductive coil, it will act as an inductor. Use of inductor to create phase difference is not possible because main winding also have inductive characteristic. So both current can act as same and phase difference will be zero. So that's why my final conclusion is I can use capacitor or resistor to create split phase induction motors. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. I am going to continue this quiz series further, in which I will discuss different important questions with electrical fundamentals. Basic will be stronger. So thank you very much. Don't forget to like.